I have put together a deck that I think is very fun to play, and I call it Bionic Weenie. Three of the top four decks in Historic are control decks, with the fourth being a mid-range deck, and what better time than now, I feel, for White Weenie. This is your traditional White Weenie deck, except we are splashing blue. I just dropped my mouse. For Miscast. Miscast is a counter spell, costs one blue, counters target instant or sorcery spell unless its controller pays three. Now that hits all sorts of sweepers, and those are the things that we are not going to want to see. But it also has a couple other problematic cards for control. For instance, Esper Sentinel, which will hopefully draw some cards. Dauntless Bodyguard, which can save another creature. Brave the Elements. Thalia makes a lot of their spells. Oops, that's the wrong Thalia. Thalia makes a lot of their spells cost more. Doesn't exactly have the best interaction with Miscast or some of our other spells, including some of these Honor of the Pure type effects. Flowering of the White Tree, a single copy, as well as three copies of Rally the Ranks. But other than that, it's pretty much a White Weenie deck. Boros Elite, we're hoping to be attacking with three creatures that'll be able to trigger this battalion effect. A Recruitment Officer, Thalia's Lieutenant, great card. This is basically a humans deck. Banalish Marshal also helps pump the team, and a single copy of Ranger of Eos. There's probably better four drops, but I like Ranger of Eos. It can help us maybe grab another Recruitment Officer, grow our hand. So let's play some games and see if we can win with Bionic Weenie. But first, do you need a desk? Because this episode has been brought to you by FlexiSpot and their new Comhar Standing Desk. If you're one of the thousands of people who like to place things atop other things, then a desk might be for you. And what better desk to purchase than one from FlexiSpot? Now, I've never had a desk that plugged into the wall before, unless you count that one time I stayed at that CD motel. But this desk is awesome. USB ports for all your charging needs, memory presets for multiple members of the family, and drawer space for easy cleanup or just to hide something you're ashamed of. Sleek and stylish, it also has a child lock button so you can instantly lock up children. Actually, it's for something else. So what are you waiting for? Stop writing on the floor. Order the Comhar Standing Desk from FlexiSpot today. And we thank FlexiSpot for sponsoring this video. All right, Bionic Weenie, let's hear who we're paired up against. Arosiar. All right. We have 3-1 drops, 3 lands, and a Brave the Elements. We'll keep it. See if we are up against one of the many control or mid-range decks that seem to be very popular in the Historic format right now. Esper Sentinel, pass the turn to Arosiar. Mountain. Ooh, this is a red deck. Do I want to block here? No, I don't want to block. No blocks. I should be able to get some. Some cards, hopefully, off a burn spell with my Esper Sentinel. So this is one of the types of, we're gonna play Brave the Elements here, save our Sentinel. Red was not one of the decks that we were thinking about when we built this, but we'll see how we can do. Oh, we'll pass the turn. Spitfire. Pass the turn, and we should be able to start using our Recruitment Officer here. Another Spitfire. Whenever you cast a non-creature spell, surveil one. Activate Recruitment Officer's ability here. Let's get a Thalia's Lieutenant. Italia, and Lieutenant in tow. Don't want to attack. Should I attack? Why not attack? Let's go crazy. Yeah, that's... Okay. Yeah, probably shouldn't have attacked. That was a good card! Oh well. Probably a little overzealous there, but we'll see. See how we do. Because that would have been a nice card to have out. To interact with what presumably interacts with these Spitfires. Hopefully we're slowing them down with this Thalia a bit. They're thinking. Surveil one. That's good. Career. So they double block. So I'm just trading these? Don't want to do that? No attacks. All right. Well, we might be able to pump our team here next turn with this Banalish Marshal, which our opponent has seen. See if that affects or informs what they're hoping to do here. They'll surveil. We're also in good shape. We can untap as normal because... If we draw a spell, we draw a spell. If we draw land, we'll be able to both play this marshal and activate our recruitment officer. These are just unblockable, so. One flies, one. More surveilling. Down to 9. Something tells me I'm not going to survive past my next turn. Now, what exactly do we want this card to be on the top of the deck? Brave the Elements, I think, would be really good, because that might be able to do it. It's not that, but it's a land. Marshall. Another Banalish Marshall here. Down to 1. Am I dead? Let's find out. The land. All right. That could be good. Okay. Pass. Attacks, not good. Hey, and we did it. All right, well, this deck wasn't set up to play against red decks per se, but still managed to get a win. Let's see how else it does in the ranked format. All right, let's see who we're paired up against here. Roy Batty. Roy Batty. All right, so this is the type of hand we generally are looking for. One drop, two drop, three drop. We got some protection here in the form of miscast. A couple lands. We'll keep this. See how we do and see what we're up against. Fabled Passage, grabbing A. I say forest. Snow-covered island. I could not have been more wrong. Hollow Fountain untapped. Dauntless Bodyguard, pass the turn. We also happen to draw our third land, although this is gonna get pretty painful real fast. We don't have the best interaction here with Thalia and Miscast. Do we want to hold up Miscast? Let's hold up Miscast and cast our Esper Sentinel. Maybe we might even be able to draw a card in the process. One thing with this deck is you're always trying to balance curving out with holding up mana. Generally, the things you want to counter with this deck, since you're lower in the curve, are four mana and above. Death Touch. That's relevant. Well, now we're just... Let's just attack and see what happens. Locks. Do we want to just pass the turn? This is tough. Probably should have played the Marshall there. If I'm making any misplays, please let me know in the comments. And I will hopefully be able to learn something from it. Couple here, down to 14. Lots of cards in hand. Resolve this thing. Resolve something from the graveyard to the battlefield. Well, they got some big things here. So I'm glad we held up this miscast. And that's the cool thing about Miscast, is because you got a white Weenie deck and you're not necessarily thinking of Counterspell, and you're definitely not thinking Miscast. So you can get to surprise some folks. Now let's play this, because we still have another Miscast that should be able to save us from most things that would really harm us here by overextending, and hopefully get the win in. See what our opponent has. It's a snow-covered island, it's a faceless haven. Miscast will not save us from a planeswalker. But will it save our opponent? Good game. Well, that was just a few examples of Bionic Weenie. I think it's a really fun deck to play. It's a great deck to play on Arena. You get to attack, you get to hold up mana, you get a lot of different decisions to make. Let me know what you think about this deck in the comments below. If you like this type of gameplay video, or if you have some thoughts or suggestions for future gameplay videos, a format or type of deck that you'd like to see, please let me know in the comments as well. And thank you so much for watching. Bionic Weenie. Why is it bionic? There's nothing robotic.